The discussion about parasitic loads and the accuracy of clamping on or putting the meter in series got me to thinking the other night, and I laid awake thinking about how I would test for that. And what is the accuracy of the tools that I'm using? How accurate are we down here at something with a pretty small load? So what I've done is I've taken this Council Lab lighting board, and I've powered up the license plate light. And you can see just a little bit of light here from the license plate on this, shining against the leads. I've made up a 10-turn bundle coil of wire, and then I've daisy-chained some meters together to carry the load. So here's a 189 fluke. Okay. Here's a 167 fluke. These are carrying the load. This is the actual. Here's a Vantage Pro. So I've got two of the fluke meters that pretty well agree, and it appears to me that the Vantage Pro is off by, gosh, 2.5 milliamps. So, and none of these are recently calibrated, so take that with a grain of salt, if you will. So I also have some clamp-on meters. I have this meter, and I have the Midtronics PDF 40. And of course, if you move the wire around in here, you're going to get a little different reading. And each of these need to be zeroed fairly often. But I'm pretty happy. I have been very happy with this Midtronics meter and its accuracy down into these ranges. I also have the MODIS set up with the snap-on low current probe. And next to that, I have the Fluke probe. These are all fresh batteries, and I have them set up to next on the Fluke set up on the old Fluke 98. So it's fairly close. But you know, if I move the probe around, you know, we get some differences. Obviously, we're talking about 24 milliamps DC. So, of course, through the meter, it's going to be more accurate. Can I be close enough with the clamp-on meter in the center of the lead? I'm fairly happy with that. Just food for thought. Thanks for listening from Bellingham Technical College.